When you think of fungi, you're probably picturing mushrooms, right? But certain fungi are microscopic and pathogenic, like the fungal organism Batrachochytrium dendrobatidis, or BD. It causes the disease chytridiomycosis and was discovered in the 1990s, and has caused a bunch of amphibian population declines and potentially even extinctions around the world. I'm an ecologist, and I study pumpkin toadlets and how drought is affecting their susceptibility to BD. Frogs can get infected with BD in water, where the fungal zoospores are able to swim with their flagellum and move towards the frog's skin. They then embed in the skin and grow into a thallus, which is a slightly bigger structure. The thallus forms a germ tube, which allows it to infiltrate deeper layers of the skin. After a few days, that fungus keeps growing and forms into a zoosporangium. Rhizoids begin to extend out of the zoosporangium and leach energy and nutrients from the frog's skin. The zoosporangium develops over the course of a few weeks and produces more and more zoospores. Eventually, the discharged papilla opens up and releases the zoospores, which can be transmitted to other frogs through host-to-host contact or back into the environment, like a pond or stream. They can also travel along the surface of the frog's skin and cause reinfection of the same individual. Once the infection gets bad enough, it causes a hardening of the skin called hyperkeratosis, which affects how the frogs are able to breathe through their skin and keep their electrolyte balance in check. From what scientists have documented so far, it looks like BD can infect thousands of amphibian species, but they don't all respond to infection in the same way. Some species, like the pumpkin toadlets, are very susceptible, and other species, like American bullfrogs, are pretty resilient. Understanding these differences is just one of the many puzzles that we're trying to solve so we can develop better tools to help amphibians fight off this fungus.